Mizo means me, means people.
Yeah.
And Zo means a.
गाइस पिछले एक डेढ़ घंटे से मैं स्ट्रगल कर रहा था ताकि मैं कुछ अच्छे ढंग के ड्रोन शॉट ले पाऊँ, लेकिन इस मौसम में जो ड्रोन के शॉट्स लेना है वो ऑलमोस्ट इम्पॉसिबल हो गया है। अकेले इन बादलों के कारण नहीं, इन बादलों के साथ जो हवा आ रही है वो ड्रोन को साथ ही लेके चली जा रही है, क्योंकि अपनी ड्रोन है बिल्कुल छुटकी सी बच्ची सी DJI मैविक मिनी, और मैविक मिनी इतनी हार्श कंडीशन में आप ढंग से इस ड्रोन को नहीं उड़ा सकते हो। बाकी जो आप पीछे माहौल देख रहे हो ये पिछले दो तीन दिनों से देख रहा हूँ मैं। कल था मैं आइजोल में, जो आपने लास्ट वीडियो में देखा होगा, उसके बाद मैं सुमो पकड़ के यहाँ पर आ गया था। पहले मेरा प्लान था कि यहाँ से मैं जाऊँगा बांग्लादेश बॉर्डर के पास, लेकिन आज है संडे और संडे के दिन मिजोरम के अंदर हर चीज़ बंद होती है, चाहे वो आइजोल हो, चाहे वो लुंगले हो, या फिर कोई भी जगह हो। संडे के दिन जाते हैं लोग, पीछे क्या देख रहे हो आप? हाँ जी, संडे के दिन लोग जाते हैं चर्चेज़ के अंदर, लोग प्रे करते हैं, और इसी बात के कारण मेरी जो क्यूरियोसिटी थी वो और बढ़ गई कि भाई यहाँ पर चर्च इतना स्ट्रॉन्ग कैसे है और लोग रिलीजन के साथ इतने ज़्यादा कनेक्टेड कैसे हैं। संडे के दिन नॉर्मली आजकल मार्केट हर जगह खुले नहीं रहते हैं, लेकिन बहुत सी जगह पर खुले लग गए हैं, लेकिन मिजोरम के अंदर बसेस भी नहीं चलती हैं और जो सूमोज हैं वो भी नहीं चलती हैं। इवन मैं जब बाहर खाना खाने के लिए गया तो मुझे कुछ भी नहीं मिला, तो इसी लिए फिर मैंने सोचा क्यों ना यार इस चीज़ के ऊपर एक वीडियो बनाते कि भाई हाँ जो मिजोरम है इसके अंदर चर्च और क्रिश्चियनिटी वो इतने स्ट्रॉन्ग कैसे हो गए। और इसी बात के साथ मेरे दिमाग में ये भी आता है कि भाई क्रिश्चियनिटी तो यूँ मान लीजिए आप मिजोरम के अंदर 19th सेंचुरी में इंट्रोड्यूस हुई होगी, क्रिश्चियनिटी से पहले यहाँ पर कौन सा रिलीजन एग्जिस्ट करता था? एज़ पर सेंसस 2011 जो मिजोरम की अभी की डेमोग्राफीज हैं उनके हिसाब से 89% लोग यहाँ पर क्रिश्चियंस हैं, 8-9% यहाँ पर बुद्धिस्ट हैं, 2-3% यहाँ पर हिंदूज हैं और 1% मुस्लिम्स। ये तो हैं यहाँ के रिलीजियस डेमोग्राफीज। और अभी मैं यहाँ के जो लोकल्स हैं उनसे एक बार मिजोरम की थोड़ी बहुत हिस्ट्री भी पूछने वाला हूँ, और यहाँ पर जो क्रिश्चियनिटी की हिस्ट्री है उसके बारे में भी मैं कोशिश करूँगा कि आप लोगों को बता सकूँ।
व्हाट्स द नेम ऑफ द चर्च?
Savish Memorial Baptist Church.
And how old is it?
I don't know.
You don't know, it's okay.
अभी हेनरी और उसके फ्रेंड मुझे एक भाई साहब के पास लेके जा रहे हैं और उनको मिजोरम की पूरी हिस्ट्री पता है कि भाई मिजोरम के अंदर क्रिश्चियनिटी कैसे इंट्रोड्यूस हुई, कैसे यहाँ पर जो ब्रिटिश टाइम पर जो मिशनरीज थी उनका कैसे इंट्रोडक्शन हुआ, और उन सब चीज़ों के बारे में मैं उनसे पूछने की कोशिश करूँगा। फाइनली तो गाइस फाइनली मुझे एंड्रयू मिले हैं, और एंड्रयू से मैं मिजोरम की हिस्ट्री और मिजोरम के कल्चर के बारे में और ज़्यादा क्वेश्चंस पूछने वाला हूँ।
हेलो एंड्रयू।
हेलो प्रांशु, थैंक यू सो मच। आई एम एंड्रयू एंड आई एम डूइंग माय ओन प्राइवेट बिजनेस हियर इन लुंगले।
या
आई एम 40 इयर्स ओल्ड नाउ एंड आई एम अ फादर ऑफ 3।
वाओ, सो एंड व्हेन डिड यू गेट मैरिड, लाइक एट व्हाट एज?
When I was 23 only, I got married.
And what's the normal age of marriage in Mizoram?
Usually, let's say,
yeah,
25 to 30 is the one of the convenient time. People get married usually during that age.
As we see, the currently 90% of the population of Mizoram is following Christianity. So when did Christianity arrive in Mizoram?
Christianity arrived on 11 January 1894.
It was bring by the Britishers?
Yeah, Britishers. Before the Christianity came to Mizoram,
yeah,
there was a like how to say a fighting between the Mizo people, and during that time there was a British officer.
Yeah,
he brought his girl child, 4 or 5 years of age.
Yeah,
and we call her Mary Winchester. Mary Winchester.
Yeah.
Then she was captured suddenly. Accidentally captured by the Mizo hunters.
Uh-huh.
Then she was brought to Mizo Hill. the Britishers trying to take back her. Then they came to Mizoram in 1871
to Tlabung. Tlabung is where I'm going today, and Tlabung is near Bangladesh.
Bangladesh border is like only 2 kilometers from Tlabung.
Those Britishers were, how to say, separated into three groups.
Okay.
One group came to Tlabung, and the other group came to Aizawl side. Then the others from the Burma side. So they are surrounded the whole Mizoram. Then the one who came to Tlabung was T.H. Lewin. Then he was successful in capturing back the little girl from the Mizo chiefs. He took back the little child. Then after taking back to the British, hearing about that captured little small girl, then they send these missionaries to Mizoram. After 20 years.
After 20 years, they send missionaries
to Mizoram.
Uh-huh. And what was the religion before Christianity?
Before Christianity came to Mizoram, we have our own primal religion.
And can you name the religion, or there was no name?
No name as such. We call it in Mizo, Pipu Tesakwa, means the religion before the Christianity came. It signifies just like that. Uh-huh. All Mizo are Christian now, but among our ethnic group, when we say Mizo, more than 10-20 people,
tribes
are get together to form the Mizo culture. Okay.
और अभी मैं एंड्रयू से मिजो लैंग्वेज के बारे में पूछना चाहता हूँ कि भाई जो मिजो लैंग्वेज है वो कौन सी फैमिली से बिलोंग करती है. जैसे हिंदी हो गई इंडो यूरोपियन लैंग्वेज, और पर्शियन भी इंडो यूरोपियन हो गई, और अगर अपन साउथ इंडिया की तरफ जाते हैं तो साउथ इंडिया वाली उस लैंग्वेज को क्या बोलते हैं, जैसे साउथ इंडियन लैंग्वेजेस हैं वो अलग फैमिली से बिलोंग करती हैं. तो मिजो लैंग्वेज की फैमिली और मिजो लैंग्वेज के जो अल्फ़ाबेट हैं वो कौन से यूज़ करते थे, पहले कौन से यूज़ करते थे और अब कौन से यूज़ करते हैं.
क्रिश्चियनिटी केम, दे गिव अस दिस अल्फ़ाबेट. The language is belonging to Tibeto-Burman. Mm-hmm. Then we understand, not 100% we understand each other, but at least 30 to 40% we understand each other with the Burma people, those who belong to this Tibeto-Burman tribe.
And is there any similarity between Mizo and Naga language?
Yes, some are similar, some.
And before Britishers, do you have any written script of the Mizo language?
No.
So it was just only vocal language?
Yeah, it's only oral.
How the people used to write something, like if I've taken some money from you, let's for example.
Okay.
So how you used to write those things in older times?
It seems they just do it in a picture form.
So there was no written language
Older times? No written language.
And currently, Mizo language is written with the help of English alphabets.
Yeah, English alphabet.
Mm. And what is the meaning of Mizo?
Mizo means me, means people.
Yeah.
And Zo means people dwelling in the hilly area.
And Ram means?
Ram means land.
Like people of?
People living in high places.
It means Mizoram.
Yeah.
The church is really strong here, yeah?
Yeah, the church has so much voice in even in the politics, and not only really in on its religious form, in even in the society. The church have a very great voice here. Yeah.
Great voice and great power. Yeah.
Great power also. See, when we come to election, like we call here village council election.
Yeah.
If you are participating in village council election, you must be one of the leader in the church. It's
really
Wow. It's more or less connected now, because people have a trust on those people who are deeply involved in the church, even for the society. They are interconnected. No more before Christianity came, there used to be a violence now. In village
people are fighting,
riding each other and all. They are fighting each other. But after Christianity came, all those things become ceased, not ceased.
Like all stopped. Things become peaceful.
Yeah, peaceful. Like,
today is Sunday and everything is closed. And for me, it's kind of a different thing. Like everything is closed and people are going to church. Mm-hmm. When this thing is started?
I don't know exactly when it started. But see, even some shops will be open. Very few shops will be open.
Yeah.
But those are also asked to close, even by the church. And if you want to sell something but you have to do by closing it and selling it. People will come inside.
Like kind of black.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. They'll do like that.
Okay, and alcohol is totally banned in Mizoram?
Yeah, very previously. Last year it was permitted, but from this new government came and they do this, what do we call, total prohibition.
Why is it? Like, why there's a total prohibition of alcohol in Mizoram?
Mainly because of the pressure of the churches. Pressure by the churches. Mm-hmm.
Andrew bata rahe hain ki jo unse drug trafficking hoti hai wo Mizoram ke through hoti hai. Yani Burma se drugs aaye Mizo ke through, enter hue India ke andar aur Mizoram se phir Assam aur Assam se phir baki jo India reh gaya. Aur isi karan se jo church hai usne ye decision liya. Last year tak yahan par jo alcohol thi uske upar prohibition nahi tha, lekin is saal church ke pressure ke karan Mizoram ke andar total ban on alcohol.
तो एंड्रयू ने मुझे चर्च की पावर्स के बारे में तो बता दिया था, लेकिन फिर मेरे दिमाग में ये चलने लग गया कि भाई चर्च को इतनी पावर मिली कैसे?
Even before the British church came, Mizos or all the tribals, let's say, we are religious. We are much more religious than, let's say, than the plain people.
Yeah.
Then after the Britishers, after those missionaries came, we are following this Christianity. The whole Mizos are within 50 years we run into this religion. Yeah, we have a very strong connection with the church. Like if you are not involved good enough in the church means you won't have any voice even in the society, even in the office. Suppose you are an IAS officer,
yeah,
Mizo,
yeah.
And if you are not involved in the church means people will not see you in such a
in a good way.
Yeah, good way.
Oh, so if you are not connected with the church, your social status will be really low.
कल जब हम आइजोल से चले थे, तो सुमो वाले भाई ने एक जगह पर सुमो रोककर प्रेयर स्टार्ट की थी.
Not only the sumo, even all the private vehicles will stop somewhere to pray when they are traveling somewhere.
Yeah.
And even in the if you go to institution, go yeah. to some schools, in every morning they will start at the school with the prayer. Go to offices, they'll start it with the prayer, even in all the government offices. So you cannot just separate the Mizos and the Christianity. They are just like a culture, no? It's.
And how about atheism in Mizoram, is no?
Let's say there is some few people will be there, atheist.
But society don't look at them in a good way?
No, not at all.
Is there any conflict between Chakma people and Mizo people due to the religion or no?
Like they are Buddhists, so it's due to this religious problem. I don't think there is a fight, but
there's a social difference.
Yes, between. Yes. So social difference is there, and language barrier is also there. The Chakmas, they are speaking quite a different language.
And the interesting thing is, Christianity and Buddhism are totally different from each other.
Yeah, very different.
Like what kind of Christianity people are following in Mizoram? It's Baptist?
Protestant. Yeah, we are all Protestant. In the southern parts, we are following the Baptist. Presbyterians are here. In Mizoram, the Presbyterian comprises the most.
So is there any, some kind of like head of the churches of Mizoram?
We have our headquarters.
It's in Azol?
No, even in Lungli we have our own.
So there is a district headquarter of the church and then there is a state headquarter of the church, the main.
Yeah.
And is there any connection between the Christianity of Mizoram and the Christianity of Nagaland?
Yeah, there is a difference.
There is a difference?
Yeah.
Okay.
Especially in Mizoram, the church are what we call, we are centralized. Centralized means we are connecting each other,
okay.
All the churches. Mm-hmm. If you go to Nagaland, churches are different. Uh-huh. They are not connecting as such, okay?
Okay.
They have all what they call their local autonomy, local church. If you come to Lungle, it means here, this is our church.
This is our church.
Mm-hmm. We are contributing money.
So it's run by the community also?
Yeah, run by the community. But all the contribution will go to their headquarters.
And they will separate the money
according
to the need.
Yeah. But if you go to Nagaland, they will not contribute as such. They will have our own autonomy of individual churches.
That particular church?
Yeah, particular church. That's our difference.
So in Mizoram, churches are kind of
centralized. Yes.
And like they are collecting funds from everyone, and they are distributing funds to everyone.
Everyone, yes.
Okay.
In Nagaland, they are local autonomy. Big churches can become so big, but small churches are very small in Nagaland. But in Mizoram, we are almost the same.
So, yar, Andrew ne mere bahut sare doubts clear kiye hain. Thanks a lot, Andrew. And abhi hum ja rahe hain jo church ki prayer.
Here are my kids. They want to.
Yeah. What's your name?
I'm Randy Moya.
You have to remember your name.
Tell your name.
Moses. I'm Grace.
Yes.
चर्च के अंदर अभी हम चर्च के अंदर जा रहे हैं और चर्च के अंदर अभी प्रेयर चल रही है. द मेन प्रेयर हैपेंस ऑन संडे.
या संडे इज आवर डे ऑफ सेलिब्रेशन. यूजुअली द होल डे वी आर गोइंग टू द चर्च.
या
देयर यूजुअली आर 3 or 4 सर्विसेज हियर.
लाइक व्हाट काइंड ऑफ सर्विसेज दे लाइक
गिविंग. दिस इज अ सर्विस फॉर द यूथ, पर्टिकुलरली दिस सर्विस. इन द मॉर्निंग एट अराउंड 10 वी हैव अ कम्युनिटी सर्विस एंड आफ्टर दैट देयर विल बी अ small gap. And after that, a service for the youth. Then
so now it's night, like this is a service for the youth.
Yeah, youth service.
It's in Mizo language?
Yeah, all Mizo language. Come.
एंड में मैंने एंड्रयू से यही पूछा कि आपको क्या लगता है लोगों ने क्रिश्चियनिटी को क्यों एक्सेप्ट किया, जबकि जो आपके पुराने रिलीजन थे उनका क्रिश्चियनिटी के साथ कोई कनेक्शन नहीं था. तो एंड्रयू का यही मानना था कि क्रिश्चियनिटी से पहले भी जो मिजो लोग थे वो काफ़ी रिलीजियस थे. वो बैड स्पिरिट और गुड स्पिरिट्स में बिलीव करते थे, और क्रिश्चियनिटी के आने के बाद जो आपसी ट्राइब्स में फाइट होती थी वो भी कम हो गई थी. एंड्रयू ने मुझे एक बात और बताई. मिजो लोगों ने जब क्रिश्चियनिटी के 50 ईयर सेलिब्रेट किए थे, यानी जब सिल्वर जुबली सेलिब्रेट की 1944 में, उस टाइम तक 80-90% मिजो लोगों ने क्रिश्चियनिटी को एक्सेप्ट कर लिया था. और इन्हीं सभी चीज़ों के कारण वहाँ पर क्रिश्चियनिटी और चर्चेज इतने स्ट्रॉन्ग हो पाए.